Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning.
This is all about peace today. Our theme for the season. We're going to start with the chant, Om Shanti. If you would like to join with me, please feel free. I encourage it, I welcome it. And it gets you into it as well. Get into the moment and into the service. Into spiritual presence.
To see peace inside my heart.
Shakti Om, yeah. Om 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 Shakti Om, yeah.
Quiet place gives us a chance to just give some love and then bring all the energy sometimes. So if you want to just raise your hands and one of them in the direction of our beautiful musical maestro, Dale Petrelli. Ah, I thought a little of that too. Thank you very much. So welcome everyone. Welcome to the Center for Conscious Living. We are here today in massive outpouring of love. To you, through you, with you, as you, and amongst all of us. So please allow yourself to take a nice deep breath and that Om Shanti energy and let yourself feel the presence of you and all that is around you, supporting you and loving you this morning. Welcome.
Welcome, CCL. Welcome to Zoom committee congregants. Thanks for being here, everybody. So we have practitioners around the room and around the Zoom to take any worries, doubts, limitations, negative thoughts that you might have. Give it to them. They will take it and release it so that none of us have it. You can take it back at the end if you want, but I recommend you let it go. So let's bask in this service right here, right now. Let's let go of the day, the hubbub of the day, and just relax into this moment right here, right now. And if you'll repeat after me, I open my heart to the universe, accepting love and joy.
I open my heart to the universe, accepting love and joy.
I open my heart to the universe, accepting love and peace.
I open my heart to the universe, accepting love and peace.
I open my heart to the universe, accepting complete health.
I open my heart to the universe, accepting complete health.
I open my heart to the universe and to be present in this moment.
I open my heart to the universe to be present in this moment.
And so it is. And so it is. So if we'll take a nice deep breath. Now that we're centered in this moment right here, right now, we open our hearts to the knowingness that we are individualized expressions of the divine. We bask in this knowingness. We bask in that still small voice that guides us, loves us, supports us. Knowing that this service is the activity of God, that we are here by divine appointment, divine love, that we are open to the presence of the divine, knowing that the divine flows through every aspect of this service, flows through Dale, sings through her, plays the music through her, flows through Reverend Catherine, Reverend Paul, Reverend Marlene, that we step aside and let the divine flow through, that we open our hearts to each other, that we see the magnificence, the beauty and the divinity in each other, knowing that we bask in this service, and we relax into that knowingness of our magnificence and of each other's magnificence. We listen for the nuggets of truth, the abundance of truth, and know that truth and integrate it into our lives, into our knowingness. We remember the truth that we all know, the truth in our heart that we're so in tune with. And we remember, and we remember, and we remember, and we practice and practice and practice. And in this remembrance and in this practice, we say, and so it is.
In this season of peace and nonviolence, I decided to choose a song that Stevie Wonder had recorded many years ago. And I think it's one of his greatest masterpieces. It's called Songs in the Key of Life. If you have an opportunity, please revisit that album. It has so many important messages that are still relevant today. This is one that I want to share with you. It's called Love's in Need of Love Today. And when we get to the chorus, if you don't mind, I would like you to sing Love's in Need, Love Today. Love today, right away. If you can sing that as I am singing, and you can, I'll tell you when, but if you can do that, Love's in Need, love today, right away. Hate going round.
That's for me. So this morning's reading has been around for a while. It's by my favorite author, Ernie. As most of you know, Ernest Holmes. But Ernie and I have a one-on-one relationship. So. It is our prayer for world peace. So just close your eyes and just embody these words. I know there is but one mind, which is the mind of God, in which all people live and move and have their being. I know there is a divine pattern for humanity. And within this pattern is infinite harmony and peace, cooperation, unity, and mutual helpfulness. I know that the mind of humankind, being one with the mind of God, shall discover the method, the way, and the means best fitted to permit the flow of divine love between individuals and nations. Thus, harmony, peace, cooperation, unity, and mutual helpfulness are experienced by all. I know there will be a free interchange of ideas, of cultures, of spiritual concepts, of ethics, of educational systems, and scientific discoveries. For all good belongs to all alike. I know that because divine mind has created us all, we are bound together in one infinite and perfect unity. I know that all people in all nations will remain individual but unified for the common purpose of promoting peace, happiness, harmony, and prosperity. I know that the deep within each person, the divine pattern of perfect peace is already implanted. I now declare that in each person, and in leaders of thought everywhere, this divine pattern moves into action and form to the end that all nations and all people will live together in peace, harmony, and prosperity forever. So it is.
Time for affirmations. Who would like to stand so we can gather these? We've been hearing we've been on the edges of a lot of participation this morning, so we're going fully in on the affirmations. They're in your bulletin. You do not have to stand, but if you would like to, we'd love to have your participation. Are you ready?
Yeah.
I am one in the field of love.
I am one in the field of love.
I am graced in the beauty of peace.
I am graced in the beauty of peace.
My hands bless the world around me.
My hands bless the world around me.
And my heart holds all that is
in love.
And so it is. Thank you.
Participation is so important, so we can hear it all throughout the room, all throughout the city, all throughout the nation, everywhere. Our loving will change the world. We have to believe that.
Loving will
Today is one of those days, and many of you may know what I mean, because all of us have our own idea of what one of those days means.
Yeah.
It's one of those days when you wake up thinking one thing, and then it changes, and it changes, and it changes, and it changes. And every time you interact with the world in some way, something changes. And then you begin to realize that that's actually the way it is every day. Every day. Moment to moment, everything changes. What I also noticed was the less I'm aware of that, the more it builds up to feel like something big is changing. And it feels a little like my car stalled on the highway. I'm still sitting here thinking everything's going my way. And there's like a kaboom when the person behind me, the truck behind me, or the circumstances of today don't match where I'm sitting anymore. Anybody had a day like that? Yeah. Okay. So you might wake up in the morning and suddenly find out you have COVID. Now, dang it. How so many people are having COVID now when they think it's passed and we're all like, no, it's good. No, it's here. Some people wake up in the morning, and as our friend Kathy Miller would like you all to know, she has baby on the way in her life this morning. So her son Harrison and her daughter-in-law Mindy are on the way to the hospital as we started today. That was just when I walked into my kitchen because I am staying at Ann Blanchard's house by the grace and glory of Ann Blanchard, which has now become somewhat of a hotel for this beautiful congregation. So I got to hear and see Kathy Miller coming through with that information this morning. So we take a moment right now and just send that blessing to Mindy and Harrison and this beautiful baby who has no name other than the fictitious Mordecai, which we shall see what happens in the next few days as this birth comes onto the planet, whether that sticks, which could be cute or not. So we're holding this moment of celebration. And then also for Kathy, because yesterday, our dear friend Glenn was diagnosed or tested positive for COVID, Kathy needs to stay home. So we feel it. Things have changed. As you might imagine, there could have been a couple expletives expressed in what was going to happen next. But the honoring that something had changed came in fully. Something had changed. And now the experience that was planned, that was going to be the experience, is no longer going to be the experience. And so we find ourselves this morning walking around the house saying, how is this for me? 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 This is for me. How is it for me? Because we know in the places of these moments where we really want to resent the universe for how it has arrived, or even perhaps if we don't have a worldly or global view, the person who arrived with COVID, when we want to take whatever's happening within us and shove it to the outside and put it with someone else or invite it to be their problem so we can just shove it out onto them and then we can just be mad over there, because I mean, where did they get it? How many times have these conversations gone through? Last time we were here when many of us had COVID and some of us were just sick. I got the questions I got from the people I was near were all about, how can I find you at fault because I'm furious about my situation that you exposed me, right? So it's like, how can I find you at fault? And I just recognize the humanness. Everyone just take that moment and just go like,
How fast do you want to just look outside? Who's to blame for this? This is not going my way. You know, and I, to tell you a little personal story, my siblings do not ever say this to me. Okay, this is a secret. Secret. My siblings used to call me Lucy. Lucy Van Pelt. Do we know who that is? Yeah, of the peanut? One of their favorite phrases was, oh, big one, what do we do now? Because I always had the answer, but most of the time it wasn't the answer. And so then most of the time it would fall apart. And then their comeuppance was to simply ask me, oh yeah, well, what do we do now? So in that way, we all can feel that way that we like to take whatever has changed, whatever moment to moment has changed, and we like to strangle it, like, please don't change. We're like, oh, don't change. If I bring it over here, maybe it won't change. I'm just mad and it changed, but it still changed. And now I'm mad. But we know that when things reorganize, there is a bigger picture reorganizing. And I hate to break this to you because this was hard for me to get, but it is not actually all about you. There are other people. Go ahead, have that moment. It isn't. It really is that this amazing universe that we live in organizes itself around the power of love. This is a self-organizing process. This is what we call coherence. This is what we call harmony. This is what we call, oh, those beautiful moments when you wake up and today is just like this until it's not. The universe is always conspiring for our highest good. Now that means our highest good. Every single beingness, every quark, every particle, every wavelength, everything counts. And you, because you are it. So if we step outside and say, well, what about me? We're forgetting that we are it, and we are being pulled into this grand spiraling energy that invites itself to be sustainable by the fact that we're breathing in this universe. Now, that doesn't mean everything has to be breathing, because rocks are part of this. Stars are part of this. Maybe they breathe. I don't know. We need to remember that we are in this grand circularity, in this conversation that sustains itself, that we call the ever-expanding universe. And once we recognize that we are playing a much bigger game with today, then we start to notice today that everything's changing. So you may wake up with some idea about what you're going to do today, and it may completely change. Someone close to me yesterday had a death in their family. Very close to me. And I didn't know how, as the person was traveling across the world to get home, we were going to connect. And yesterday afternoon, when we were singing, those of you who came, thank you for coming, but those of you who didn't come, just to let you know, as we were singing, one of the choices that Wayne had made for songs was a song about grief and joy coming together. Oh, grief, oh, joy, come together so that I don't fall apart. So as we sang that, I sent it up to the airplane that I knew my friend was flying somewhere over my head to get home. And I feel myself entering a different realm with this. This was not what I thought I was doing a couple hours before, because I had just found out. Notice your life. Notice. So what else happened that we've been aware of that has been in the field of some of grief this weekend? Tyree Nichols. I'm so sorry if I've said his name wrong. Send love everywhere. No one heals from hate.
We are entering the season for nonviolence. Martin Luther King. Hate never healed anything. I have his words jumbled around in my head. Love heals. Love heals when we pour it towards those who are perpetrators and those who have been victimized. Love heals, period. When we were listening to Dale's song today, love, when it's hard to love. Love when you want to blame. Love when you want to hate. Love when you want to separate yourself from the change that just happened that may look like your loved one or your life or your work or your religion or your anything, body, suddenly changed. Love. It is the only thing that heals. Love beyond, love at the back of, love within, love beside, love through, love as, love. It is the only word we have for this great organizing principle that is good. And it holds everything. There is not one thing, not one thing outside the field. It is either love or it is a call for love, which is love itself calling you to bring love here. Where do we need love in the police department? Where do we need love in white people's minds? Where do we need love in Black people's minds? Where do we need love in the hearts and minds of all people? Where do we need love? Reverend Michael Beckwith, who is my first mentor in religious science, said to me, the newspaper is a prayer request. Do not read it without praying first. The newspaper is a prayer request. Anything you see, give your love to it. Do not be afraid of it. Do not turn away from it. Do not pretend it isn't there. You don't have to listen to it. You don't have to watch the videos, but get the information in a way that doesn't traumatize you, but get the information and then look at it and bless it and pour your love as if your knee was cut or your baby was crying. Pour your love. Pour your love everywhere. And what do we need first? We need that love within us to actually be grounded and centered and whole inside us. So we need to do this work. We need to claim for ourselves that I need to give myself love. So when I'm having a moment, when I'm feeling like heat in my body, love is all I get to do. Love is my essence. It is your essence. It is the essence of life. And as we turn within and pour the love into the places that are screaming inside us, how is this for me? What is mine? You will hear an answer. You will hear an answer. And the one answer that you know you will always hear is love more. The Course in Miracles says, if there's anything missing from a situation that you're in, it's you. What are you not giving? If you're standing in the middle of something and there is something happening that you don't like, give what you like. Give what you love. Do not enter into the conversation of duality. Give into the wholeness. On Friday night, Wayne and I were in Philadelphia and we could hear the crowd yelling behind us. We could see the police on high alert. We could see them shutting off streets. And I was walking with this awareness of a protest going on somewhere in the dark behind me. This is not my favorite place to be. I just want you to know, I have unfortunately been in that situation in America and in other countries, and they do not always stay behind the police barricades. And I was walking along and we were going to a very loving event, which was fantastic, the Ethical Society. And we went in and we were dancing, and I stood in the middle of the room and I sent this just field of love out everywhere I could. And I don't know if it's going to be me or everyone else on this planet, but let's have Philadelphia be peaceful tonight. I don't know what might happen when I'm walking out these doors. And then I let it be. And when I walked out those doors, everything was peaceful. They found their way together. Whatever was happening remained peaceful. There was a protest, and for goodness sakes, there should be. And no one had to have a traumatic, violent experience, because we are speaking our truth. We are standing in our truth in a way that love is coming through. So as you consider your day, as you love yourself, as you touch into every single thing that might annoy, bug, threaten, hurt, demand, grieve you, touch yourself first with love. When you are full, give it back. Know that you are powerful. No, I am not saying that I created that whole peace thing in Philadelphia. Just to be clear, I am saying that that was my contribution, and I stayed in a place that I haven't always been able to stay, in a place of love, with it sending out the vibration I could send to meet all the other vibrations that were being sent, to hold that process in peace. The more of us that do it, the higher the probability that this will be the voice that is heard in all the hearts and minds of everyone around us. We create reality we choose to live in. Be love, be peace, and bless those who have gone before us. We bless all those who have any suffering of any kind, anything, anyone who has sacrificed their own life in any way, meaning or not meaning to, for us to get this message. So today we will not sacrifice this message, turning against the white police. We will turn with them, and we will hold them accountable in love. We will hold them in the place where love does not behave this way, and that we will keep them safe until they figure that out. But we will not have this in our society. And we stand for that. We will have love. And we will take a stand for love. We will hold people accountable in love. And if Gandhi can do it, we can do it. And so it is. And so we take this moment to pray for this congregation, that we are all here today. Anyone who is here, anyone who is not here, anyone who is on Zoom, anyone on YouTube, anyone, no matter where you are, you consider yourself a member of this congregation. You are with us today, blessing this space, knowing it as holy. Here or on your way, in the ethers and the great lands of the great light, we are one. And this community knows that as we commit to this kind of a thing, as we say, no more will we blame our anger, hurt, and grief on others. We will love whatever needs our love. And we will hold this love. And so this community holds itself in love. We hold this beautiful Kathy Miller and the baby and all that's happening there in love. We know that all is well. We hold my daughter and her little baby coming in, and whenever it's coming soon, in love. We hold all the children of this congregation, all the grandchildren of this congregation, all of the innocence of life, we hold with love and hold as precious. We hold every member of this congregation, of this world, of this planet, of these galaxies, of the expansive universe, of the earth and down into the magnetic core. We hold it all, knowing that it functions with us, in us, as us, through us, in the holiness of the divine perfection of the unfolding eternal life, which we are. as we bless all this with the deepest gratitude for the knowing and the remembering and the holiness of this moment, know that you are the one we have been waiting for. Take that seriously with the deepest gratitude for all the gifts that you have ever been given, for we have ever been given. We bless this community. We are blessed as a community with great, abundant love, joy, peace, financial resources, beauty, nature, all of it. And so is the world. And we hold anything that inside us doesn't look like this. We hold it all in love. And we let the love permeate and return to love. So grateful for all of you, for your presence here, for your hearts, for your consciousness, for your love. And right here and now, we anchor this energy on this planet, this place of good. We plant this divine idea into the soil of this holy space, and we let it be. And so it is.
All right, we're going to put our hands together for this one. Thank you, Reverend Catherine, for that message. I think you all needed that today. Holy, holy way.
Holy, holy way.
Oh, let me rise in a holy, holy way.
Let me rise.
So we take this moment to turn within, and we give great thanks for all that we already have. We look around us, we look within, we see the great resources that we have been given, the great resources that we have, the great resources that lift us into this place of knowing the wholeness and the holiness of where we stand today. And we bless this community that we are in. We bless this loving, we bless this heart and soul of all who we are. And we allow ourselves to dig within the depths of ourselves and allow the overflow to crest over with love all that we receive. And from this grateful, full, powerful overflow, we allow our gifts to come forward. Our gifts of talent, our gifts of time, and our gifts of time. We welcome all of that. In this congregation, you are the congregation. We are the body of this love. And together we create this beauty. And so we take this moment to thank those who came together this morning for us in service. So, John Fulmer. There you are.
Went somewhere else.
Thank you so much for being here with us today. For Tim and Sarah Della.
Yeah.
You may or may not be in the kitchen right now, right? And I'm not wearing my glasses. That is why I'm stumbling over this. And for Jane and Holly. Set up this morning,
or Martha was set up this morning.
For anyone who came in the last minute, for Reverend Paul and my beloved Wayne, who have been rearranging our video audio and will in the next few weeks make a difference. For Marty, who is on background, it really takes all of us, right? We need everyone, and we need those of you who come to church. And
Marlene. Us girls have to stand up for each other.
Yeah. Stand for. Yes. So, and for Reverend Marlene. And for love that she brings. And for those programs that we're holding in your hands that are, of course, not here without her. For Dale, for the music, and for every bit of the love that is here as you today. Thank you. Thank you, thank you. So from this overflow, from this gratitude, from this grace, we invite you to give your gifts, your offerings, your tithes to this community so that it may grow in its influence, in its impact, and in touching the world with this message of love. Thank you for your blessing. This is John Fulmer.
Physical shirt.
Yeah. Oh, God.
If we'll all read the blessing of our offering together. Thank you, God, for this moment to share. I bless this gift and give it to thee.
In gratitude
and joy.
We've done a lot to receive.
I am so blessed. I am so grateful for all that I have. I am so blessed. I am so blessed. I am so grateful. I am so blessed. I am so blessed.
Okay. Usually I go over there.
Okay. Oh, as we all take a breath together, we bless these gifts. What has been given from your overflow, knowing that in this universal language of abundance, that all is given and all is received, as is in perfect alignment. We bless this gift. We thank you for your offerings, and we let it be. Amen.
So at this time, we have a blessing, and it's for all of us, but especially for anybody that's here for the first time. If you will dare to stand up, if you're here for the first time, you do not have to.
If you feel new today, just go ahead and stand
up. Yeah. So you get to stand and receive, okay? Everyone else is going to hold their hands up and send you this blessing. You repeat after me, welcome to the Center for Conscious Living.
Welcome to the Center for Conscious Living.
We are a heart-centered spiritual community. We open ourselves to you in love. We recognize the perfection of God within you. We celebrate the joyous being that you are. You are a radiant point of light. We are blessed by your presence. Welcome home.
So, I have the most amazing group of helpers. It is, I swear to you, it is such a gift. People follow up for me a lot, and it keeps me from dropping things. And so, I just want you all to know that I deeply appreciate your reminders. So, if you're ever in doubt, text me, call me, or remind me if I've forgotten something. In the meantime, I'd like to invite June Hammett to come and talk to us this morning about the Season for Nonviolence.
Peace and Nonviolence.
Season for Peace and Nonviolence. Really, what's true is it's really the peace of season. Season of love.
That's what it is.
It's a season of love. So I'm going to let June take over and talk.
Peace and love.
Peace and love.
That's good. Terrific.
A bumper sticker that says love world peace.
Yeah. I know. Prince of Peace. So I had all sorts of things I was going to say today, but you've already said it. And Dan has already said it. And Marlene has already said it. And we're going to say it again. And again. And again. So this is the season for peace and nonviolence at CCL and around the world. It's a global phenomenon. And it is the 10-week period between the memorial of the death of Mahatma Gandhi and the death of Martin Luther King. Both were assassinated. So that's why we're talking about nonviolence. But what they were talking about was love and peace, both of them. Mahatma Gandhi said, "My life is my message. How I live is what I am saying." So that is what the season is about. And we've been celebrating it here for about 20 years, actually. It started at the United Nations in 1998. And we started very shortly thereafter. What the season tells us is that every person, each one of us, can move the world in the direction of peace. And that's through our nonviolent choices and our actions. Dr. King said, "Nonviolence is the absolute commitment to the way of love." Sounds very New Thought. Yeah. He also said, and this is also very New Thought-y, or actually any wise person would say, "We are all caught in an inescapable network of mutuality, tied into a single garment of destiny. Whatever affects one directly affects all indirectly. This is the way the universe is structured. We will have peace on Earth when we recognize the basic fact of the interrelated structure of all reality." Sounds very, very familiar. So every year, for the last almost 20 years, many of us, there's a rotating team of people who have been participating in the Season for Peace and Nonviolence here at CCL. And every year we've been doing something like a short meditation or a discussion or a practice on a theme about peace and nonviolence. But this year our team is going to add in actually something a little different. We are, and I've said this before, I'll say it again, we are an awesome community. We don't just talk spirituality, we do things. We're out there in the world doing awesome things. And many of us don't know what the other folks here are actually up to. So we're going to be bringing some of the things and highlighting some of the great actions and service projects and so on that people have been doing for years here. We're going to be highlighting some of them here, and we'll continue through the rest of the year. This is just the start. There are going to be a number of outreach projects and so on that we've been engaged in, and we're going to have some opportunities over the next 10 weeks for people to become engaged with those opportunities if they want to. Some service projects are coming up. So we'll be sharing this with you over the next 10 weeks or so. And whenever one of these events or opportunities comes up, we're going to put it in the newsletter. So where have I heard this before? Read your newsletter. It's going to be fun. The news can be pretty disturbing. We should pray before we read the newspaper or not read the newspaper at all. But to be aware of our contribution, because as another wise person I know says, that it's when spiritual people become active, and when active people become spiritual, everything can change. So, as we have had in our tradition, we usually gather around our peace pole. Who remembers the peace pole?
Wow.
Yes, all right. So we're going to have to imagine our peaceful, as John Lennon says, imagine, because it has a different home somewhere, and we don't know where. About 2 years ago, in March of 2020, we had to vacate this place in a hurry and clear out everything. And the peace ball, which is quite large and doesn't have feet, so it didn't walk anywhere, was picked up by someone, we don't remember who, and moved somewhere, and we don't know where. But it isn't lost. It's just misplaced. So if anybody has any recollection of that happening, please let us know, and we will retrieve it and put it in its proper place, right here in the center of our community. So the peace pole says in a number of languages, may peace prevail on earth. And there are thousands and thousands, maybe tens or twenties of thousands of peace poles around the world. Ours is one, and we are holding a place of peace right here at CCL.
There's actually one in Riverton.
There's one in Riverton, and there are a number of churches around the area and in people's homes. So what I would like to do now is ask our team for today to stand. And we're going to, I don't know. It's right there. Oh, where is it? It's right there in the middle of the aisle. Right there. You see it right there?
Visualize your peace pole.
There's our peace pole. It's about.
Be the peace pole.
I am the peace pole. As are we all. So we're going to.
We lost you on the camera.
Sorry. Okay, I'm there. And so is the peace ball. In fact, the peace ball is right here. I'm at this. I love this. So we're going to be repeating after our team member speaks the words about peace on earth. May peace prevail on earth. And will you all repeat after that? May peace prevail on earth. Who's number two?
May peace prevail in North America.
May peace prevail in South America.
May peace prevail in South America.
May peace prevail in Africa.
May peace prevail in Europe.
May peace prevail in Asia.
What number are we saying?
May peace prevail in Antarctica.
May peace prevail in Australia and the Pacific.
May peace prevail in our homes and families.
And may peace prevail in all of creation.
Thank
you.
Okay, does everybody see this little thing here? I'm holding my hand. This is my phone. And what comes on my phone every Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, or Friday is a newsletter from CCL Community. So I'm showing it to you so you know that it probably comes on your phone too. And there's so much cool stuff in here this week. It was so long. Thank God we didn't have to print it, right? So we started, and I just really want to do the announcements relatively quickly, but I really want to send you, because we have links that work. You can register for classes. There's so much cool stuff on here, and you can register for all sorts of stuff that I'm going to tell you. But you can't if you don't read it. So we are going to hide some little toys and gifts in there. You guys have any ideas about how to do that? But it can't be easy because you guys are so smart. So we were remembering Trader Joe's, many of you, they hid little toys, stuffed animals in the rafters for the kids. So when you could shop while the kids were looking for the turtle or the woman. So we're kind of doing that. So anyway, we're going to send your hearts into these newsletters because they're really full and there's lots of exciting stuff happening. So first of all, Wayne and I would like to thank you. Thank you, this community, for so much generosity, so much congratulations. And then to come home from our honeymoon and have a cake was just tremendous. Flowers and balloons, gifts, just, you know, thank you. And really, really, we were totally surprised and totally open and grateful to receive that gift from all of you. So thank you. We want you to know, we did have a sing-along yesterday, so some of you read your newsletter because you got there. And that was really fun, and we'll be doing it again. So you'll see it if you look in your newsletter. It's gonna get really old fast, isn't it? Okay, so one thing we also want you to know, Season for Peace and Nonviolence comes with, if you press the button to register, a 64-day daily practice. How it shows up for you is in an email every morning with a beautiful graphic with one word, a tiny little message, and a little action for the day, like love yourself, or think about forgiving someone, or something like that. And they're all, they're inner practices for a third, they're community practices, and they're world practices. So it gives you a chance to kind of play around in the realm of what would my life be like if I started living this way. So it's a beautiful email. I promise we will never send you anything else attached or ask you to buy anything or any of those things. We will sell your email. We know you'll be back to talk to us about it the next week. Anyway, yeah, we sold you down the street to that other church. So please go. It is a really nice packet. If you forget, you will remind you, because you'll just have to get into the stream after the first day. And the first day is Monday. That is tomorrow. So if you want to get in the stream and be part of this, I consider this New Thought Lent, which gives us a chance to really dive into the possibility of how deeply we can love. And so with small practices and little reminders every day, it's a good opportunity to play. I am teaching a class. I called it about six things. Experiential spiritual inquiry seminar. We don't know. So what it is it's an opportunity for you to come forward and play. Ask questions, dive deep, bring a reading, say, I don't know what this means. So we can, as a community, ask some big questions, maybe have some fun, maybe push against the edges of what we all believe, maybe giving us a chance to really go deeper. Now, there is no prerequisite for this class because we recognize that people come in from all walks of life, from all levels of awareness, and from all teachings. And you are all welcome, okay? Every single person. We're doing it as a six-week class because we want to create a group of people who can feel the enjoyment and the connection that will come from being in a class together, and then we'll run it again. So if it's not your time or you're not ready, we'll try it again. But this time, we'd love to have your presence. We'd love to have your inquiry. I'd love to be there with you and see what the things are that are on your mind or on your heart. The question is too little. People ask me things like, what is love? Talk about it all the time. Or what is God to you? What is God to this church? What does that mean? How do we define that? So when you're in the question, we've had people come and talk to us about what they think this represents, this group of people, and it isn't always what we're trying to represent. So if you want to really know, if you want to really play deeper, we'll have poetry, we'll do some mysticism, we'll do some inquiry, you'll get a sort of splash of a lot of things. We'd like you to take this opportunity to enjoy the experience of being part of this community and class that you can fully participate in, because you are going to be creating it with me as we go. Great. So that is there. Also, Reverend Paul and Marlene, and I will be with them also. We'll be teaching spiritual practice class, which you've seen before. Some of you have taken, but if you haven't, it's a great class. It's a little bit, it it's deeper than a survey class, and it has Ram Dass's book about all the different kinds of meditations. And we talk about prayer. We talk about praying with each other, not just for yourself, all things like that. So it's a great class. We love, they love to teach it, and they don't mind when I join. So we're gonna all three be there together. And that is coming up really soon. So that starts on February 2nd. If anybody is considering being in a practitioner class in the fall, that class needs to be in your toolbox by then. So this, we have a free seminar workshop that was just designed for us that is about prayer. And it literally registered for free, it says on your newsletter. So it's on a Saturday and at the end of February 25th, 1 to 4:30. We're giving this so that we can all hang out together for free. And we're gonna have a lot of love. The reason we want you to register is so we have the right size room, so we know what's happening, okay? Also, just to let you know, we have been given another gift for the Holistic Healing Expo. So we're gonna be there. We would love anybody who loves CCL to come hang out. We're gonna hang out there. I'm gonna hang out there. I'm not gonna commit them. I'm gonna hang out there all day. So we're gonna see, you know, who comes, who wants to talk to us, why do they want to know more about us and what we love, okay?
What's and the
that's a March 19th, so that's in the future. That's just, we're giving you a little heads up, but we do need people to sign up to have specific times. It doesn't matter if you can't make it, because you've got, look, all these beautiful people who are going to do it for you. And then we're going to have a new members gathering at the end of March, where we really want people to come to talk to each other and meet each other and gather, and that will be not on a Sunday, somewhere and not in this building, just to have a chance to love up on the new members, and who knows what will happen with that. But that is it, and then there's a couple other things in there, which I'll save for you to figure out when you get there. But in the meantime, anything else? Just Marty wants you to know that you can still buy those food books. They're $10, and you can feed yourself for a long time. There are books on the back table. Marty has those books. There are books on the back table for a gift or donation. And we have, if you want your goals still, if you want to give us your goals to pray over, they are still welcome. And they are welcome all the time, of course. And we will continue to do that. Okay. So thank you very much for your patience. It is late. This has been quite a morning, hasn't it? So let's jump back in here, and we are going to gather in a circle.
Circle up.
We're gathering around the peaceful. Around in a circle around the
peaceful. I could be the peaceful.
Let's just imagine it.
Yeah. No, you're going to. Yeah, I'll be the peaceful. I'll be the peaceful.
I want to be a Catholic.
Peace eternally. Let there be peace on earth. collective breath together, knowing that the essence of the divine is breathing us. It flows in and through every cell of our bodies. It is that beautiful essence of love. We are love. We are loved. We are loving to ourselves, to each other, to this community, to the planet. We are that. And I know that as we leave each other today and go back out into the world, that we take that love, that loving energy, and we just allow it to flow. It leads our path. It follows our path. It is our path. For there is nothing else but that love. Grateful for the opportunity to be here together as a community, in person, on Zoom, connected in every way and shape possible. Grateful for Reverend Catherine being here in person today, sharing her insights of love and change. Grateful for Reverend Paul and for Wayne in putting together all the brand new opportunities to connect with those on Zoom. Grateful for Marty and June and Jane and Martha and John and Anne and all those that were in service today. It takes a village to put this sacred space together. And that is why we are here. And that is part of what we are grateful for. And knowing that everything is always guided, always directed by the divine. I am knowing that. It is all as it should be. And just take a breath and say with me, and so it is.
So it is.
If you'll repeat after me. Something wonderful is happening to me right now.
Something wonderful is happening to me right now.
It is this thing called life.
It is this thing called life.
Life is in my body.
Life is in my
mind.
Life is in my
feeling. Life is in all my activity.
Life is in all my activities.
I receive it.
I
share it.
I share it.
I am it.
I am it.
And I accept it.
And I accept it.
Just the way that it is.
Just the way that it is.
Thank you, life.
Thank you, life.
And accepting all these great gifts, we say,
Yes!
Joanne, how you doing? I can't hear you. Hi, Ann. Hi, Mary. Hi, Glenn. Hi, Bobby. Hi, Nelsu. Hi, Joanne. All right. It's hard to hear. Hey, Mary.
Hi, Bobby. Congratulations, Cal.
Thanks. I'll let you know.
Yeah, we can't wait to hear the good news.
Yeah. Exciting.
Yeah.
Glenn, I'm just quarantining. Glenn, he's doing okay, but he's not COVID.
Have you had it yet?
I never have, no. Nor has Glenn. And hopefully I won't get it, and if I, whatever.
Yeah.
We'll see. I'll go down there on Wednesday if I don't get it, so.
Good.
All right. So prayers for that. All right, kids. Good to see you all. Love you.
Love you, Bobby. Bye, Glenn. Feel better.
Yeah, we're gonna stop recording.